and feeling left out because his life had changed to such a degree that he couldn't just hang around as a normal bloke.
And soon he was taking out his frustrations on those closest to him.
Marc was violent towards women. I was witness to the aftermath of a situation with Gloria, in Chicago, where he gave her a black eye, and she had to get out, and she stayed in my room for the night.
Who are these people to even know anything? Were they in our home? Were they in our bed? Who, you know? There just comes a time that you have privacy.
By 1975, Bolan's singles were barely scraping into the top 40. It looked like his dream was finally over.
He was devastated, but he was forgiving. And that's when he became his own man. And that's when he was blessed that his son was born, because he had hope again.
And it was really cute, because I mean, it looks like me, so it was really, and it's an amazing thing.
Yeah,
I'm hoping it's going to stabilize me somehow.
Yeah.
It's just a miracle, mm. I reckon. Babies, you know, they just plop out.
Yeah.
You know. And he came out dancing. He was getting down.
When Roland arrived in this world, Marc did change overnight.
Both my mum and dad and I, we were pleased that he was sorting himself out, because you could see that he was looking healthier.
In 1977, the cleaned-up and newly focused Marc got another boost, the chance to resurrect his career with his own TV series.
Welcome to a new show called Marc. Could be a lot of new sounds, a lot of new experiences.
Said I love to boogie, I love to boogie.
He was serious, he was dedicated to the television show because he had been given a chance. And there were a lot of stipulations. And there were a lot of rules, but he was humble enough to do everything that they wanted.
He embraced the whole idea and took it very seriously, cleaned himself right up.
You better sneak out with your tail feathers high, jitterbug lift and smile to the sky.
And I think it was a beautiful result for him.
The six shows proved a big success, and on the evening of September the 15th, 1977, Marc went out to celebrate with Gloria, who'd recently flown in from the USA.
High school boogie.
That night, Marc looked at me all evening with admiration, and he asked me to sing for him. And I sung, Who Can I Turn To? And he was sitting there, and I can remember he was like, that's my glow-glow.
But the night ended in tragedy. As Gloria drove them home through South London in the early hours of the following morning, their Mini crashed into a tree, killing Marc instantly. Gloria faced accusations that she'd been drinking and was to blame for the crash, accusations which were never proved and which she's always denied.
We had been driving 45 minutes and didn't have any problems. We were on a road that had many, many accidents at the same spot. If we had been in a larger car, he would have been alive.
Do you ever waking up in the middle of the night and think, in another 20 or 30 years, I'm going to be 50 or 60. What shall I be doing then? You don't.
Never think about it. I mean, I don't think I'll live that long.
You don't?
No.
I was dancing when I was 12. I was dancing when I was 12.
At the time, I was shell-shocked, and I still feel the shock today that he's not here in our life.
When you get a death in the family, it's just pure grief. Everything just floats around you. You fight to carry on living and get through the grief as best you can.
I dance myself right out the window.
was lost, and what saved my life was having my family, having my son.
I celebrated my second birthday in the hospital, and I shared my tea with her. And while her jaw was wired, she looked, you know, just wasn't in good shape from the accident. And really, she never really told me that much, and just the fact that he loved me. Is it strange to dance so soon? I remember my dad's parents bought me a little portable 45 player. And of course, some of the records were T-Rex records. And I used to sit there and play all these songs, and, you know, I'd get into it. You know, the music is definitely what has brought me close to him. I dance myself into the tune. I dance myself into the tune.
This month marks the 30th anniversary of Mark's death. Since then, Gloria Jones has moved to Sierra Leone in West Africa, where she now helps run an orphanage in one of the poorest areas of the capital, Freetown.
I was dancing when I was 8. Is it strange to dance so late? Is it strange to dance so late?
Mark's son Roland lives in Los Angeles, where he now works as a musician.
I've never tried to be my father. I've never looked at him as a hero. I've never, you know, I just know that was my dad. And unfortunately, we weren't together, but I have the music to listen to.
Isn't strange to dance so soon? I dance myself right out the womb.
I think his music is as popular today as it ever was. He's an enduring figure. He was such a talent.
His legacy is with us all the time. There is a bit of T-Rex in every band.
You run over here for Telus, Goldfrapp, Oasis. The music's there.
I think right now he'd love all these artists that are kind of taking bits and pieces from him. That's the best tribute that could ever be done. And a tattooed girl, ride a white swan that the people of a belting. Where your hair long, babe, you can't go wrong. Catch a bright star and a place it on your forehead. Say a few spells and baby, there you go. Take a black cat and sit you down your shoulder. And in the morning you'll know all you.
Hi.
Ready to go?
Thanks.